In this example, we're going to take a look at the NDVI curve for Maine, United States. So NDVI stands for Normalized Difference Vegetation Index, and roughly speaking is an indication for how much vegetation is at a given pixel, okay? So let's make this query and then discuss it in a second. So we create a query. We're going to select from satellite data, once again MODIS, and then the NDVI channel here. But let's also add some temperature data, okay? So specifically from the PRISM data set, the daily minimum temperature. So why are we doing this? The reason is the following. We're going to look at November and December of last year, and we're going to see a drop in the NDVI, okay? And one of the reasons why NDVI drops in a large area is because of the onset of snow. Okay, and obviously we could try to look for snow directly, but minimum temperature together with precipitation is of course a reasonable proxy for snow. So we're just basically going to look at, you know, whether we have a temperature drop at the same time as we have an NDVI drop. So as to where, you see now, because PRISM is basically only existent in the continental US, PAIRS has drawn this rectangle about the continental US, indicating that the daily minimum temperature that we're interested in is only available there. Of course, we are interested in Maine. We select the polygon directly. So let me say next. So now for the when, we pick November and December of 2017. Okay, so we need no aggregation for this query. We simply want to compare the time series. And now we can give this query a name. And we submit it. Now, instead of waiting for this query to finish, let's simply look at the version that we ran previously. It's down here. So this now is the NDVI data for Maine, okay? And what we can do now is, you see on the left, there's a button animate. So you see when I click this, it starts loading the complete time series. You can see here while the image is changing, how the dates change. And you see here now in December, it's very clear that, let's pause this here. So if we go from November 25, you know, where the values are like, and also red means close to one is reasonable high amount of vegetation. If you go from November 25 to December 11th, there's quite a dramatic drop, okay? And so usually when you have a drop over a large area this large, that should pretty much sort of what you're expecting. So to take a look at this, let's compare the daily minimum temperature. You know, of course, this is very homogeneous because it's daily minimum value. But if we just select the time series here by just clicking somewhere, and then we specify to November, December. Well, we can see the trend here, okay? So roughly speaking, this crosses sort of the freezing point at the beginning of November. Let's look for a different point. Yeah, roughly speaking, the same story. So this is a very slow trend, but this might indicate that this is due to snow, okay? At the very least, we see that the temperatures indeed sort of dropped around here at the beginning of November, so that the snow set in somewhat later in December around here is actually quite reasonable to expect.